वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, श्री मुलिका देवी महाविद्यालय निगोज तालुका पारनेर डिस्ट्रिक्ट अहमदनगर. इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी वॉज लर्न द मेथड्स ऑफ मलबेरी प्लांट हार्वेस्टिंग. इन दैट वी आर स्टडी द फर्स्ट मेथड्स ऑफ मलबेरी हार्वेस्टिंग, दैट इज ब्रांच कटिंग मेथड ऑफ मलबेरी हार्वेस्टिंग, सेकेंड फ्रूट कटिंग मेथड ऑफ mulberry harvesting, and third leaf plucking method of mulberry harvesting. Now today I will discuss with you a chapter number 6, that is silkworm rearing. This is very important in sericulture activity. So let us start the silkworm rearing. Entomological division. You know, I was already told you the sericulture activity is mainly divided into three division, that is first one agricultural division, second one entomological division, and third one technical division. Out of this we are studying first division, that is agricultural division. In that we was learn the steps or important aspect of sericulture, that is cultivation of mulberry plant, then harvesting of mulberry plants, then climatic condition required for mulberry plants cultivation, and some other basic concept including agricultural division. Now today I will discuss with you the next division, that is entomological division. Why you can call it as entomological division? Because you know, in sericulture we are rearing and culturing the silk moth. The silk moth is actually one type of insect. So if you are study the lifestyle, then life cycle, external morphology, anatomy of any insect, these all the study are included in entomology. Entomology, what is the entomology? Entomology, it is a branch of zoology that deals to study of insect. So now this point is included in entomological division. Samajh mein aa raha hai aapko? Why you can call entomological division? Because the study of insect, or you are studying the silk moth, it is insect. The biological name of silk moth, mulberry silk moth, is Bombyx mori. This include rearing of silk moth. This is typical and time consuming procedure. You know, if you can rear any living organism in your farm, in your house, that will be very careful and time consuming process, because they require lots of period for whole development of particular organism. This required a complete knowledge of life cycle. Now मी ऑलरेडी आता तुम्हाला सांगितलेलं, नॉलेज ऑफ लाइफ सायकल ऑफ इंटरेस्टेड सिल्क मॉथ, दॅट इज मलबेरी सिल्कवर्म, अलॉंग विथ इट्स मॉर्फोलॉजी अँड एनाटॉमी. नाव हिअर वी आर रिक्वायर्ड द होल इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑर कम्प्लीट नॉलेज ऑफ लाइफ सायकल ऑफ पर्टिक्युलर सिलेक्टेड इन्सेक्ट, ऑर दॅट इज युअर सिल्क मॉथ. Second, you are interested in now here mulberry silk moth, that is mulberry silkworm. Okay, along with its morphology and anatomy to study the its external characteristic and internal characteristic, that is anatomy. Samajh mein aa raha hai aapko? A life cycle of Bombyx mori. Bombyx mori, it is a biological name of mulberry silkworm. Mulberry silkworm moth feed on mulberry leaves. Why you can call mulberry silkworm? Because this moth is particularly feed on mulberry plant, so that is called as mulberry silkworm. A mulberry plant leaves is the sole and base food material for a caterpillar of Bombyx mori, that is your mulberry silkworm, because it is natural food of your silkworm. They are easily feed and digest them. Silkworm required a low temperature and little moisture for rearing. This is the common information. You know, our silk moth is very sensitive to their temperature and moisture. So you can provide optimum condition to the rearing. Let us start to study of taxonomy. This is a short information regarding your life cycle of Bombyx mori. We are detail study the Bombyx mori, detail study of Bombyx mori in chapter number 2. So phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Bombycidae, genus Bombyx, and species Mori, Linnaeus. This is a photo image of life cycle of Bombyx mori. These photo images are also studied in chapter number 2. Let's just to overview the life cycle. This is a female silk moth laying eggs. Egg laying procedure. This is called as egg laying. Now, after the development of eggs, eggs will be hatch out and very tiny, small, whitish color worms, that is your silkworm worms, is come out. Then they start their life cycle or journey of life. After 10 days, you can observe this will be increase their size, growth will be start very well. So their size is increasing, young larva after 10 days. Or after 14 days, you can imagine this larva is very large in size, healthy. So you can imagine this larva is feed whatever amount of the mulberry leaves and convert into their body size is very large compared to their younger period, that is hatching period. To just compare this, next one, cocoon. Spinning of cocoon, that is the resting condition. After the spinning of cocoon completed, the cocoon your pupal stage is start. The pupal stage is completely complete in inside the cocoon, and after the development of pupa or pupal stage is completed, they will be emerge out from your cocoon. Look here, yes, itun to bahir padto. They just chew out the external covering of cocoon. And look this photo image, the male and female silk moth start the mating, and mating will be completed. After the mating will be completed, the male is immediately die, female carry the genetic material, that is reproductive material, inside their abdomen, and they starting the development of their eggs. After the development of eggs, they starting the egg laying, and after egg laying, female will be die. This is the short information regarding the life cycle of Bombyx mori. This whole the information is already covered in your chapter number 2. Let us start the actual chapter number 6, that is silkworm rearing. You know, silkworm rearing includes following points. First one, selection of varieties of silkworm for rearing. Second one, that is rearing house. Third one, rearing technique, and to study the important pests and diseases of silkworm. So these are the 4 points. They are included in your chapter number 6, that is silkworm rearing. Let us start the next first point of this chapter, that is variety of silkworm for rearing. You know, according to Central Silk Board, they are published or they are produce some hybrid variety of silk moth for the peoples, or it will be called as for the sericultural farmers. So you can just observe this tables. You are looking, these are the hybrid name as P2D1 cross with NB18. Combination of this hybrid is MVBV. This species is suitable for winter, spring, summer, and early monsoon. This is a very good species that will be called as all season this species is culture or rare in your farm. Which state is selected or particularly use this hybrid species? Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Assam, Bihar, Orissa, Jharkhand, MP, Chhattisgarh, UP, Arunachal Pradesh. These are the popular state. They generally use these hybrid. You can observe there is n number of the hybrids available according to their some basic features regarding their. Now here you can just look this serial number 4 PM cross with NB 18. Now combination is MV into BV. But this species is only useful in summer season, because whatever the characteristic, whatever the basic features of this species, is suitable for only summer season. Because if you know summer season in our country, there is a high temperature, so it is not good for the silkworm. But this species have the capability to rear in summer also. Which state is generally used? Assam, Bihar, Orissa, and MP. These are the n number of the hybrids available in market. You can choose according to suitable condition and your requirement. Samajh mein aa raha? The following races have been developed time to time by Central Sericultural Research and Training Institute, Mysore. This institute developed some hybrid variety of silkworm that will be helpful for the farmers to increase their production, cocoon production. And according to season, you can choose a n number of variety of hybrids available in market. So let us start the some bivolatile hybrid, study of bivolatile hybrids of silkworm. In that first one, that is CSR18 cross with CSR19. This hybrid is suitable for rearing throughout the year. Now you can check this cross hybrid is useful for throughout the year, means if you are interested to take silk production in whole year, throughout the year, you can choose this hybrid. But you know, every species have some basic principle or some good features, some bad features also. Okay, samajh mein aa raha hai aapko? Jari hi species all over season chalat asel, but some limitation is present. That is limitation in they are able to produce 58 kg cocoon per 100 DFLs. On an average, this production is good. But if you are interested to commercial production of silk, that time this production is low compared to the another variety. The silk grade is 2A to 3A. This hybrid was authorized in 1999. He kadhi swikarli 1999 madhi 1999 madhi this cross hybrid is published or they are sold in market during 1990. Next one, thin dinner hybrids. This hybrid is CSR48 cross with CSR4. This hybrid variety has a features of to produce long filaments of silk. If you can use this hybrid variety, whatever the silken cocoon is produced, this silken cocoon is have the ability to produce up to 1500 meter long thin filament of silk. This is a future of this hybrid. This can be used for production of fine silk fabric. If you want to fine silk, that time you can select this species. The silk grade is 3A to 4A grade, and this hybrid was authorized in 2005. रिसेंटली तयार झालेली आहे. दिस हायब्रिड शो अ व्हेरी गुड फीचर्स, दॅट इज लॉन्ग फिलामेंट अँड दे हॅव द एबिलिटी टू प्रोड्यूस थिन फिलामेंट ऑफ सिल्क ऑल्सो. सो यू कॅन चूज दिस, बट सम लिमिटेशन इज ऑल्सो प्रेझेंट. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट हायब्रिड, दॅट इज कृष्णराजा. कृष्णराजा डबल हायब्रिड, दॅट इज सी एस आर सिक्स क्रॉस विथ सी एस आर 26, डबल क्रॉस, दॅट इज सी एस आर 2 क्रॉस विथ सी एस आर 27. दिस हायब्रिड हॅव द ॲबिलिटी टू शो 100%, नॉट इन 100%, बट अप टू 95% फर्टिलिटी. मीन्स whatever you can select, whatever you can take your DFLs out of this, they have the ability to produce 95% fertility. This was widely accepted by the farmers of Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. They are, this state are particularly used the double hybrid of silkworm because they show व्हेरी गुड फर्टिलिटी रेट. ठीक आहे, लक्षात आलंय. द ॲव्हरेज इल्ड ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम दिस हायब्रिड इज अगेन दे शो व्हेरी गुड सिल्क प्रोडक्शन, दॅट इज 65 to 70 केजी ककून फ्रॉम 100 DFL. यू कॅन इमेजिन अँड जस्ट कंबाईन दिस फिगर 58 and 65 to 70. So according to this one, these are the good one. Again, this hybrid is very good in fertility rate. Samajh mein aa raha? This hybrid is authorized in 2005. Next one, Chamraja. Again, this is very good hybrid. They are recommended for throughout the years, means all the season, this hybrid is good for the rearing and they have the ability to produce up to 65 kg cocoon from the 100 DFL. 100 DFL means DFL means disease free laying. It is eggs, amount of eggs, silkworm eggs. Samajh mein aa raha aapko? Kapila, again these are the very good B 143 into NB 4D2. This hybrid is suitable for all the seasons, particularly in irrigated condition. All the season irrigated condition, these are the basic requirement, or you can rear this hybrid in all season throughout the year. They can produce up to 60 kg cocoon from 100 DFL at field level. This is very good in production and this cross hybrid was authorized in again 2005. These are the some cross hybrids, some bioholotype hybrids of silkworm species. You can select any one according to your requirement and your climatic condition, suitable climatic condition. Samajh mein aa raha? Now next point is multi holotype cross with bi holotype silkworm hybrid. In India, more than 95% commercial silk is produced from multi holotype female is cross with bi holotype male prior, that is called as cross breed. Second important hybrid is produced by the two methods, another methods, that is to use multi holotype female cross with bi holotype female parents, that is called as cross breeds. You know a very popular, that is Mysore, it is a hybrid name of hybrid silkworm cross with NB18/NB4D2. These are the hybrids to use this and produce a new hybrid, but such type of the cross hybrids have the some limitation in the cocoon weight. I was already told you, according to your species, your final production, that is silk production, is always affected. So the lower cocoon weight shall ratio is very low, and they can produce poor fiber of silk. So you can select your species, you can always study the features of particular cross hybrids. To overcome this limitation, they are produce PM cross with NB4D2. These are the new hybrids produced from the this cross methods, and these are the overcome this limitation, that is low cocoon shell and low weight of cocoon. Are you understand? This is the new technique used in production of hybrids. Now next cross hybrid is PM cross with CSR2. PM cross with CSR2 hybrid is useful in irrigated area. This hybrid is useful in irrigated area, and most important feature, this cross hybrid is useful in all the season, and they are producing very superior quality of cocoon. This cocoon is well in weight. Weight is very important, because your silk is marketed in market according to the weight. Up तुम्ही कशा पद्धतीने विकणार आहात त्याला, तर किलोच्या भावाने विकणार आहे. सो वेट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. सेकंड इज द साईज. साईज ऑफ कॉकून इज अगेन व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. सो इफ युअर हायब्रिड इज एबल टू प्रोड्यूस गुड साईज ऑफ द कॉकून, अल्टिमेटली युअर कॉकून इज वेल इन वेट. सो टू चूज सच टाईप ऑफ द क्रॉस ब्रीड हायब्रिड्स, दे कॅन प्रोड्यूस सुपिरियर क्वालिटी, pure white in color, and well weight, well shell weight. These are the some features of your hybrids. And last one, if you can use these crossbreed hybrids, they are show the quality of silk and resistant to the diseases. They are not easily affected by the any silk diseases, silkworm diseases. So again, you can study whatever your requirement. You can select any one crossbreed or multi-volatile or bi-volatile hybrids for silkworm rearing. I hope you are understand. These are the some species, variety of silkworm. You can choose any one. But before the choose or selection of any species of silkworm, you are always study their features. And final important statement, that is which type of the or how many production produced from particular hybrids. तुम्हाला त्यापासून किती प्रमाणात सिल्कचं प्रोडक्शन भेटेल किंवा तो सिल्कचा कपूर कशा पद्धतीचा असेल याचा स्टडी करणं खूप गरजेचं आहे. आर यू अंडरस्टँड? ठीक आहे. आय होप दिस आर द फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टंट पॉइंट इन युअर चॅप्टर नंबर 6. Next important point, that is rearing house. To study of rearing house, the study of rearing house includes some important point. Let us start the second point, that is study of rearing house. A separate house is ideal for silkworm rearing. You know, I was already told you that your silkworm is very sensitive to the humidity, moisture and temperature. So it is necessary to provide a separate rearing house to your silkworm, because you are starting your sericulture activity as a commercially. So if you want to increase your production, to provide some basic requirement also. समझ में आ रहा? तुम्हाला जर कमर्शियली करायचं असेल, दिस आर द necessary to provide separate ideal rearing house to the your silkworm. It is called as house of silkworm. ठीक है. The rearing house should have sufficient number of windows to permit cross ventilation. आता आपल्याला त्याचे काही फीचर्स ड्यूरिंग द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ युअर रेअरिंग हाऊस यू आर ऑलवेज स्टडी द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ युअर सिल्कवर्म. सो यू नो दे रिक्वायर्ड ऑप्टिमम टेम्परेचर इनसाइड द रेअरिंग हाऊस. सो इफ यू आर कंट्रस्टेड युअर रेअरिंग हाऊस यू आर ऑलवेज कीप इन माइंड यू कॅन प्रोव्हाइड अ सफिशियंट नंबर ऑफ विंडोज टू permit a cross ventilation or apan in marathi yala hawa khelti rahili pahijen kiwa ek vyavasthit ventilation jhale pahijen ya prakaracha tumhala tyachya madhi thodasa niyojan karun tumhi rearing house tayar karayche asta. If after the completion of your rearing house you are always focus on disinfection, because which type of the material is used in during the silkworm rearing, whatever the material, whatever the equipments are used in during the rearing of silkworm, you are always disinfectified by using some chemical or another methods. You should be kept clean and disinfectified all the equipment before the rearing. ठीक है. Rearing house is always constructed or built up in such a way to provide optimum temperature of 26 to 28 degree centigrade and RH of is 60 to 70% for well growth of silkworm. It will be minimum or optimum environmental condition or climatic condition required for well growth of silkworm. So you are always kept in your mind this rearing house should be provide or obtain the 26 to 28 degree centigrade temperature inside the rearing house and RH, that is your humidity, is between the 60 to 70% for well growth of your silkworm larva. The rearing house should have certain specification, as the silkworm are very sensitive to weather condition like humidity and temperature. You are always kept in mind your rearing house should be provide good ventilation to the your silkworm larva. So you are always kept optimum humidity and temperature. Ensure the rearing room should have proper ventilation, optimum temperature and proper humidity. Next one, to avoid the, this is very important, where you are contrasted your silk rearing house, to avoid some important point, that is damp condition, then construction should be not directly exposed into the sunlight to avoid direct entry of very strong wind in your rearing house, and last one, away from the animals in your domestic animals from the your rearing house. So if you are interested to construct your rearing house, firstly to avoid damp condition, then direct expose of sunlight into the rearing house, then strong wind should be avoided, means khup zoracha vara dekhil tumcha rearing house madhi aat entry keli nahi pahijen tya varyane, and direct sunlight dekhil, because if your sunlight is directly enter in rearing house, ultimately your rearing house temperature is increased. So you can always kept in your mind to avoid such type of the condition during the construction or built up of your rearing house. This is the ideal photo image of rearing house. You can just look it. These are the window present in your rearing house. Then you can made your rearing house in optimum height from the ground level, because to avoid the entry of any other rodent animals or another animals, they are directly not entered in your rearing house. Next point, that is features of rearing house. I hope you are understand the all the points, all the concept included in this lecture. If you have any difficulty, any problem, you can ask me in comment box. The next point, that is features of rearing house, will be discussed in next lecture. Thank you very much to all of you.